talking about masculinity is a little tricky. Oh boy, maybe I need to put up my hair for this because this might get a little messy. Depending on who you talk to, masculinity has its pros and its cons, right? The strange thing about masculinity is how easily conflated it is with toxic masculinity. There's likely some crossover between the two, but as someone who grew up being indoctrinated into what masculinity was supposed to be, what masculine traits I was supposed to be exhibiting as a dude, and ultimately what it was to be a man, I have to admit, I'm not entirely sure what masculinity truly is or means. To me, it's just mixed signals. And I say that because I didn't just learn how to be a man from my father. Yes, he was the principal influence for sure, but I've also picked up a lot of things from the people who've been in my life throughout, like my mother, aunts, uncles, teachers, mentors, coaches, friends, girlfriends, as well as media influencers and the legacies of cultural icons such as musicians, writers, artists, thinkers, politicians, war heroes, etc., etc., both dead and alive. And they all seemingly have different but similar ways in portraying or defining masculinity, a lot of which I don't necessarily subscribe to. While trying to come up with a script for this particular video, I realized that I've never really intentionally sat down to think through what I believe masculinity is. But before I could attempt to define it for myself, I realized that I had to do a little bit of research and read about how different people were defining masculinity. So I bought some books and I did some reading, everything from bell hooks, whose work really resonated with me, to other toxic weirdo red pillars whose work I'm not gonna promote here because fuck those guys. And often I realize that we relegate specific traits to configure this strong, silent, brooding, masculine, mysterious type of fella who only knows how to express himself when he's bottled up so much rage and emotion that he just blows up. But see, I think that those aspects are toxic masculinity. Are those characteristics really what masculinity is? Is there even a difference between toxic masculinity and masculinity? I don't know, I'm trying to figure that out. So let's take what I learned from my pops. Growing up, unlike a lot of my friends and the kids that I was running with in the neighborhood, I had my father in my life. I was fortunate in that regard. But I didn't really see him very often because he was always working. Both of my parents, and myself for that matter, are immigrants to the United States. Through the both of them, I learned about the non-stop immigrant hustle in order to fit in and move up in the world. But it was specifically from my pops that I had my earliest impressions of what was expected of me as I grew into a man. And it basically boiled down to two rules. Number one, your word is your bond. Don't make promises that you can't or don't intend on keeping. Without your word, you are an unreliable, flaky shell of what a man is supposed to be. I mean, would you hire a man who was unreliable and couldn't make it to work on time? Would you marry a man who you wouldn't trust to keep his fucking vows? Would you trust a man with your life or the life of your loved ones if he couldn't even make it to an appointment on time? Probably not. I'm hoping not. So what's a man if his word does not have any kind of weight? Number two, a man sacrifices for the sake of his family. Anything and everything if that's what the situation calls for. Time, weekends, sleep, every single paycheck, his life. A man should work himself to the bone if it means keeping his family safe, fed, and ahead. I think that the spirit of those two things that my pops taught me are positive as well as necessary for my own survival. But to an extent, the sort of sacrifices that were expected of me to make made me feel like my life was not my own. And given the sacrifices that both of my parents made in order to provide me with the opportunities that they never had, I grew up feeling conflicted, alone, and to an extent, trapped. And I wondered if that's how my pops always felt throughout his life. See, growing up, my pops was really hard on me. I am his eldest and only boy, and boy did that mean something to that man. In essence, it meant that we couldn't be friends. His job and number one priority with me was to be a father and to prepare me for, and to an extent, shield me from the ways of the real world. Often, that meant being severe and unforgiving. It meant breaking me down to build me back up. But on my end, it meant distrust, resentment, anger. Yet the more I didn't like him, the more I learned from him, and not necessarily just the good things. There's a lot of good things that came from those lessons, but also a lot of stuff that I'm having to confront and unlearn. However, it stands to reason that given the fact that both of my parents grew up alongside a lot of poverty, they took their responsibility as parents very seriously. And now that I'm older and I'm able to speak retrospectively and with experience, I now understand why he was the way that he was with me. And he reflects on it too. He looks at my work in progress life, and even though he wishes more for me, he's proud. He knows that I know what I want out of my life, and he knows that I know how to keep my word, and that I know about sacrifice. He laments on the time that we spent butting heads when I was younger, but I'm grateful for it. And when it comes to our relationship, he does have some regrets, but I tell him that there's still time for us, that he did the best that he could with what he knew, that he was there as much as he could have been, and he didn't fail me. And I'm very grateful for that. Through my pops, I learned about what it meant to be a man. Through his mistakes, I learned about what it takes to be a man. Through his accomplishments and aspirations, I learned about what a man could be. And maybe that's what we need to be taking into account when defining masculinity. And so that's what I aspire to. Masculinity or toxic masculinity be damned. Ultimately, what I want is to be a good and reliable man who leaves the world a better place for everyone than the world I was born into.